everybody, and welcome to Energetic Principles Monthly Horoscopes for September 2017. My name is Melissa LaFara, and I am an astrologer and tarot reader from San Diego, California. And in this video, we're going to discuss what is in store and what key dates to look for during this September period. So let's get started.
May the stars be with you.
All right, Virgo and Virgo risings. So what does September have in store for you? Well, we now have the sun in Virgo, right? You know, it moved in here on August 22nd, and so we've had a handful of days in Virgo. So for all you Virgo suns out there, happy birthday period to you. So this is a time when you're really focusing on yourself. You know, the spotlight has now moved into what it is that I want, where I want to take action, what I see for myself. And so this, you know, most of this month you're going to be focusing on getting practical and taking charge of your own life and focusing on numero uno. And this is also about working on your self identity and your image and your personality that you project to this world. You know, are people seeing what it is that you want them to see? And this is also a time where you become more aware of your own critical faculties, your ego's criticism, you know, especially Virgo, you know, Virgo rising, you can be a little bit hard on yourself. So this is a time to become aware of where that criticism may not be working in your favor, and to, you know, let yourself off the hook a little bit. Because mostly you're going to be, you know, you're stepping into your own power this month. And in order to do that, you can't break yourself down, right? And so this is also a time where you might be focusing on caring for your own body. As it, you know, this is time of your own physical health. And with the sun in Virgo, we're ultimately aware of our health to begin with. So just know the spotlight can be shining here for you. So the first day we're going to talk about is September 5th, when we have Mercury stationing direct at the eclipse point at 28 degrees Leo. And so our minds are clear. We've gone through this Mercury retrograde cycle. The mind is clear and ready to move forward. And we're basically back on track in the area of, you know, for you, it was about you've been working through some spiritual hangups and weeding that soul garden of your mind, in a sense. And you've been working through fears around areas you might not even know why you're fearful of that, you know. And you've really had to tap into your own thoughts around having faith around what it is that your life looks like, and having faith around being able to create a life of joy of what it is that you want. So you've spent a lot of time with this access to a higher consciousness, in a sense. And now you can go forward with this stronger renewal around, you know, keeping the faith around what it is that you're trying to do, and know that your mind, you know, you've kind of dispelled some things in your mind that were holding you back. So this was probably a really fruitful Mercury retrograde period for you, Virgo. So just know that going forward, you can basically transcend any worry about expressing yourself to other people and in important relationships in your life. And you probably become a little aware, you probably become really aware of where you need to let go of unconscious patterns that may be a little dramatic, or they come out dramatic through no help of your own, you know. And so you've really tapped into that energy now, and you're moving forward on stronger faith. So the next day we're going to talk about is September 6th, where we have that full moon at 13 degrees Pisces. And this is going to be a time of breakdown and breakthrough. You know, there's going to be a polarity apex for everyone, and there's going to be a release associated with that. And so for you, Virgo, it's all around your partnerships and those seventh house issues of relating to other people and making crucial decisions and choices in life. So chances are you're going to find that you're at a tug of war between your relationships and what it is that the ego needs. And, you know, are you really seeing that other person as clearly as you think you are? because, you know, that's the thing about being a Virgo, Virgo rising. You have that Pisces seventh house cusp. So you can have these people that feel like you're spiritual forevers. And then other times it's like, is that real though? Am I confused by that? So chances are you're going to have a little confusion come up around how it is that you see the other, or maybe you see them correctly, but what you don't see is your own reflection within it. So just know that you're gonna probably have some breakthroughs around partnership that can get you to a better place. And chances are you might have a conflict that will help clear the air, because the partners are gonna be wanting your attention. And you're going to have to balance out that kind of giving and receiving that you do. And really, you either might have to sacrifice for your partner, or your partner might have to sacrifice for you in order to make this work. And that's where it can get a little tricky. But hang in there, because, you know, breakthrough is imminent. So the next day we're going to talk about is September 13th, which we have the Sun in Virgo squaring Saturn in Sagittarius. And the Sun squares Saturn a couple times a year, and these are basically a couple days where we're feeling the weight of the world, and it's a day of obstacles and some temporary frustrations, and, you know, we might have to make some tough decisions in our lives and stay patient around certain things, and mostly just remain realistic without being pessimistic. And for you, that's going to be in the area of your own emotional self being able to take all that assertive action. You know, you're basically boosted up this month to take control of your life and take direction in the areas that you want to go in. But sometimes that emotional self and those emotional beliefs patterns might get in the way of you being able to really hone into your ego. Or perhaps part of that emotional release is actually tied in with your own ego, and you're going to have to try to separate the two. Otherwise, you're going to find a little disruption at your home or within your family. So chances are you're going to have obstacles. Something's going to happen probably on the home, within your home or family. And, you know, it's just a twice year Saturn transit, you know, don't worry about it. Like, you just got to get through that hump. And so this is, you know, another thing that you might want to be aware of is how can you take control of neurotic behaviors that you have. So if you find yourself like kind of becoming a little during this time, like, look into your own behavioral patterns and see if you're not making mountains out of molehills and kind of being more dramatic than it needs to be emotionally. So just know that, you know, September 13th, give or take a few days, is going to be a little bit on the challenging side, not just for you, but for everyone. So the next day we're going to talk about is September 19th and 20th, which we're going to have the new moon in Virgo at 27 degrees. And so, you know, depending on where you are in the world depends on if it'll be on the 19th or the 20th. So, you know, we're having this new moon late in our Virgo cycle here. So we're going to work on all these Virgo issues the whole month, and I won't get our renewal and our freshness until the end of it. So just know that this is a time of planting seeds and getting new projects off the ground and really deciphering what it is that we're going for the next 30 days. And for you, that's really, I think most of the month you're going to struggle with, you know, kind of steering the wheel of your own life and taking those reins. But I think by the time this new moon rolls around, you're going to be ready to go. And you're like, okay, I got this. I'm ready. I have to take charge of my own life, and I have to do it. So chances are you're going to shift into more decisiveness and be ready to act on your own direction and really renew yourself and your ego in a healthy and positive way. So the last day we're going to talk about is September 22nd, when we have our autumn equinox and when the sun moves into Libra and what we deem as the turning into fall. And this is a natural time of change where we're in this release cycle and we've had the equal day and the equal night. So for you, Virgo, you're basically going to be doing a spotlight switch into area of balancing your resources and your finances. Chances are you're going to get a little dose of like, oh my gosh, I need more money, or I don't have everything that I need in order to make these things that I'm going for work out. And so you're going to be looking to help find a little more balance within your own resources and possibly getting rid of things that no longer suit you as well in those areas. But mostly you're going to be working on your own self-esteem towards the end of the month. It's going to be the first few days where you're going to, you know, because it usually takes a couple, it takes a good 10 days for us to get into the season and work through the initial pitfalls in it. So just know towards the end of the month, you're going to probably have some self-esteem and self-worth issues come up, and you're going to begin to work on them and also really find the value in your relationships and what they can provide you in terms of self-worth and self-esteem. And so basically you're going to be balancing those areas out. So yeah, Virgo, you know, how can you really step into your own power this month and be, the best Virgo you can be and take clear, decisive action in your life? All right, Virgo. So what does the tarot have in store for you for this September? Well, we have the Ace of Wands as our focus, and then the Emperor as the grounding. And I'm going to say these are pretty powerful cards, Virgo. You know, this is, like I said earlier, this is your month. It's time to really step in to you and build these new this new growth in your life. And essentially, that's what the Ace of Wands is bringing, is it's saying focus on your vitality. You're going to feel renewed and refreshed there. And chances are you're going to have these inspirations and these new growths coming your way for you to really tap into. Your passion is going to be ignited around something. Especially your own goals and motivations and what it is that you want in life and what it is you're going after. And so you can see growth in those areas. But just know this is the initial spark of something, and it's not the end all be all. So, you know, like, take this energy, but, you know, put that good old Virgo work to it. And that's where the Emperor comes in. So that if you take this new growth and this new vitality that you're having, and you, you know, marry it with a healthy dose of self-authority and allowing your logic to reign over your emotions and to really use that power and that status that you have within, like, that's going to build that firm foundation that is needed to take this inspiration and these new ideas and these new motivations to the next level. You know, you want to have clarity of the mind so that you're able to facilitate these actions and these decisions that you're going to have to make in your life to really foster this new growth. So just know that this is a time where it's you need to stand tall in who you are and really stabilize that passion that's coming to you, because you got a lot of juice behind you right now, Virgo. So how can you use it? All right, everybody, thank you so much for tuning in. If you want to connect with me to find out more or to get a reading, you can find me at energeticprinciples.com. You can also find me on Instagram and Facebook at Energetic Principles. I also have a podcast with Shauna McGrath of Neo Feminine Astrology, which is called The Feminine Principle, Astrology for Authentic Living. And that is a podcast that comes out weekly where we discuss what is going on in the stars, along with tarot cards and inspirational quotes. So feel free to stop by. You can find that on Podbean, iTunes, or YouTube. So, you know, I'd love to connect with you and hear what you're thinking during this September season. So please comment below with what is going on with you. And if you want to stay in the know, please subscribe to my channel. So I'm wishing everybody a fabulous September and the month ahead. And as always, may the stars be with you.